So we all love the cool tech that comes with our cars these days, Apple CarPlay, connectivity, but we don't focus down on safety, and that is really important. Well, the MG Gloster is focusing on that. It's bringing you some cool tech for the safety features, and Gavin did talk about them in his story, but he didn't have time to dive into the details. Well, to dive into the details, I have with me today Stuff India editor Nishant Padiyar. He's going to get into the Gloster's brains and talk about the active safety systems.
That's right. In fact, the MG Gloster is the first car in this segment to have ADAS,
which stands for Advanced Driver Assistance System.
That's actually level one of autonomous driving. It's quite a big deal. And what that basically means in simple terms is that it's got a bevy of cameras and ultrasonic sensors. Everything works together to keep you safe and potentially out of trouble. But I'm not here to keep it simple, right? So let's get in and explore the tech.
Okay, ready to get the show on the road. Why have I put Nishant in the back seat? Well, practicing a bit of social distancing since we both don't have our masks on to be able to speak to you guys clearly. There's quite a bit of distance between the front seat and the back, so I think we're good to go here.
So Renika, while we spoke about what ADAS is, I'm going to show you what it can do, starting with something that might be counterintuitive to you. So I know that you're one of the best drivers around, but I'm going to ask you to deliberately take the car off course and off lane.
Okay,
see what happens.
I get an alert right in front of me on my screen. There's a sound too. Basically, it shows me that I am not keeping to my lane.
The lane departure warning system works only at speeds over 60 kilometers an hour and uses the feed from the front camera along with computer vision to see the lane markings on the road ahead. Hence, its effectiveness is based on the kind of roads you're driving on. State highways and expressways would be ideal for this system to work flawlessly. The system is also intelligent enough to not trigger warnings if the turn signals are deployed manually by the driver.
But, you know, I find that very often a lot of these warnings in our condition, especially parking sensors, I always switch them off because I find they go off too often. So, you know, there are times when I would want to be moving in and out of lanes and going ahead in the traffic. I assume this works on the lane markings, so you know, it would constantly be reminding me. So I need to figure if I can switch these systems off, and now that I've come to a stop at a signal, let me switch it off.
So it's a great feature to have where you can switch systems off as and when required. But the one thing I really like to use these days a lot, in fact, even within the city, because speed limits are becoming so stringent these days, and even on our office commute when I take the Bandra Worli ceiling, cruise control makes my life a lot easier. And this one has a more advanced version of cruise control called adaptive cruise control. Why don't you give that a try?
Okay, let's get it going. Press the button, activate it. I can actually increase or decrease the speed. Let's put it at 70 kilometers an hour. We are under the speed limit here on this road. It is maintaining the distance. I can even adjust the amount of distance I want to keep.
And it's also an intelligent system where it knows when you come to a traffic light, when you slow down, it will apply the brakes for you.
It just did. Yep. I haven't touched the brakes at all.
You can select one of the three preset distances, one car length, two car lengths, or three car lengths, and the Gloster will always maintain that from the vehicle in front. ACC or adaptive cruise control works between speeds of 0 to 150 kilometers per hour. So it can even come to a complete halt if need be and pick up speed, all while being adequately distanced from the vehicle in front.
Okay, for the cruise control, it's also important for everyone to know that you can activate it only once you're past 30 kilometers an hour. But once you have activated it, even if you come to a complete halt and start off again, all you need to do is tap the gas and it gets going. Even in slow moving traffic, it will keep distance to the car in front of you. So if I switch the adaptive cruise control off, is there you know, another system that will keep me safe in an emergency situation, or do I always have to have that on to be safe?
No, in fact, there are a whole host of systems that can come in even if you do switch off adaptive cruise control. And two of them I'm going to show you right now, but it can't be done on public streets. It would be slightly irresponsible of us. So I have a nice little secure enclave where we can go to. And I'm going to show off some of the systems that the Gloster is, I think, going to be known for. So now that we are in the safe zone and we have a very nice fancy MG ZS EV parked in front of us as a prop, I want you to start driving at a steady speed of above 40 kilometers an hour.
And have faith in you.
And have faith in me, believe in the MG engineers that they've done their homework.
Okay, I'll take that one.
And what we're going to check right now is a system called the front collision warning system.
Yep, I felt that. So basically what it did was I got an alert up on the screen. There was a tone. And, you know, before I hit the brakes, it kind of hit the brakes and slowed us down as well.
So the car has an array of sensors and cameras all over the car, and what it does is basically scan the road ahead of it, and the moment it senses there's another vehicle or a four-wheeler right in front of it, it'll send you those alerts which you experience.
Okay, and am I checking something else out now?
The second interesting bit, and this really requires you to have a lot of faith and belief again, because this means that the car is going to brake for itself. You have to completely take your foot off the pedal and believe that the car will
do it for me.
Yes.
Okay, better see my Hail Marys right now. And do I have to drive at a certain speed?
So for this, you'll have to keep the car speed below 40 kph.
Okay, I think for safety's sake, I'm doing this at 20. We're 30.
And you can think of any god that you believe in, but eventually MG is going to win this one.
Don't touch the brake. Yeah. That car is inches away from me. But it kind of sensed that I wasn't doing anything, and it actually brought me to a complete halt. That is impressive.
I'm inches away. I told you, remember, that this is the reason why we had to get into a safe zone, because you can't simulate something like this out on the open street.
But yeah, you have the faith that out on the open road, if something brakes hard in front of you or is stationary and you don't notice it, that the car will have your back again.
The front collision warning system and automatic emergency braking work hand in hand to save the day if need be. As the first safety net, the front collision warning system will alert the driver of an impending collision with a four-wheeler with a warning sign and an alarm. If the driver fails to respond even then, depending on the Gloster speed, either the automatic emergency braking will slow down the car by 40 kph or bring it to a complete halt if the Gloster is doing less than 40 kph.
Okay, that was really a close call. I still think I need to get some air before we do anything else.
That's true. I mean, I'm sweating from places I never knew I had. But to make it easier for both of us, we're going to line up two cars, and I want to show you one final bit of very interesting technology. It's called automatic parking assist. And I'm pretty sure you're going to like it, because your hands will be completely free of all the hard work of getting into a spot.
Good way to call it a day. Let's try it. Okay, so Nishant, what do I have to do?
So as the final piece of the magic, we have these two cars lined up, and there's an empty parking slot right in between. All you have to do is press a button on the center console. Let the Gloster take over. Sit back and relax.
This says parallel parking. I'm guessing we want vertical. Yes, it has an option for that too.
Typically, the most boring part of any drive, parking is always a chore. Thankfully, the automatic parking assist on the Gloster uses ultrasonic sensors on the front, side, and rear of the car to identify an appropriately large parking spot. These sensors emit and receive signal back from any obstacles around the car, and the system's computer will use time of flight to determine the exact position. All you have to do is follow the prompts to switch gears from drive to reverse and feather the brakes. Steering inputs are completely automated, and the Gloster is a stickler for perfection. It won't stop until it has centered itself between the two adjacent cars with equal space on either sides.
And we have success.
Job done.
Job done. End of day for us. Ooh.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, MG.
a full-size SUV with a huge laundry list of active safety tech features, I think the Gloster makes a very strong case for itself. This is the first time MG is bringing all these features to this segment, and I think they're putting technology where it matters the most to protect your loved ones.
Well, as a family car, most definitely it's spacious, it's comfortable, and it does back you up. But what one has to remember is this is just a backup. Don't take your eyes off the road or your hands off the wheel or your foot off the gas or the brakes because you think the car will take over for you. Driver intervention is always important, and that is a must. I also feel that sometimes the alerts may get a bit too much, so you may often find yourself wanting to switch them off. But I have to say that the systems work extremely well when activated.